In this lesson, we'll take a small detour and discover some basic functionalities in app.tsx. App.tsx is automatically generated from our template and usually will be the start in your coding process when customizing the iTwin viewer. Before we start making modifications, let's get a basic understanding of our app.tsx file, the main entry for the iTwin viewer. I mentioned earlier that the iTwin viewer is written in TypeScript and it uses React components. If you're completely lost on the syntax and functions here, you can learn more about React at reactjs.org. So jumping into our app React component, we have two variables we use here called iModelID and iTwinID. These might look familiar since they correspond to the .env variables that we filled out in the previous lesson. The access token contains the user token used for all API calls to our iTwin platform. And in order to get the access token, we need to define our authorization client. And this is where the authorization environment variables kick in that we filled out in the .env file. Moving further down, we have a login function here, which tells our authorization client to first try to silently log in the case that you're already logged in. Else, if that fails, we do a proper signup. Then we jump into our use effects, and this is when the app component first initializes. So what do we do first? We call login to make sure the user is signed in, and then we check for the two iTwinID and iModelID variables. If these aren't set, we'll throw an error. Else, we call set iTwinID and set iModelID to let our viewer know which iModel to target. It both checks out. We'll change the URL to match our iTwin and iModelID to help us identify which iModel we're looking at. Or if desired, we can even change our iModel using the URL itself. We can skip view configuration here. This function will just try to provide an optimal view of the iModel on open. And finally, jumping into our render. So we'll break this down. In the viewer container div, just check if there is an access token. If there is no access token, we render a signing in component with a spinner, and then it will try to log in. And if we already logged in, we render the viewer component. And again, looking at the three variables that we filled out at the top, we pass them in as props. The viewer will take care of everything behind the scenes, and that pretty much sums up the app component. As we continue to customize our viewer, we'll add more props. You'll often see us referencing this viewer React component as we continue to extend and customize our iTwin viewer.